morning.
Good morning.
How is everybody today?
We're fine.
Good. So we had a little problem with the wick, and I thank Carol for stepping in and wanting to light the candles, but then the wick was gone. And you know what? That is a great example to all of us. You know, we walk in our daily walk, and sometimes we just lose His light. Amen? But that's why we're here this morning, to bring that light back, so that we be restored and refueled for the week to come. Amen? So, let's praise God. I will praise the Lord with my whole heart in the assembly of the upright and in the congregation. Let's have church. Good morning.
Good morning.
A couple announcements as usual. Sunday school is 9:30 a.m. every Sunday morning. If you would like to join us, you're more than welcome. We'll have Bible study this coming Wednesday at 11 a.m. We're studying different characters of the Bible using the book They Walk With God by Max Lucado. And Pastor Cyndi has printouts if anybody would like one of those, either up here or downstairs. Choir practice on Thursday at 6:30 p.m. We didn't have a choir today because Sally and Karen are away, and we didn't think we'd do justice to the song, so we'll be back next week. Suit sale, there's a form in your bulletin to pre-order. Today is the last day for that, and pickup is Friday, February 9th, between 3:30 and 5. February 11th at 7 p.m. next Sunday, Mark Allen Chapman will be here in concert. And February 14th is Ash Wednesday service at 7 p.m. Excuse me. Is there any other announcements?
So for those of you that hear about Mark Chapman on February 11th and think, oh my goodness, next Sunday is the Super Bowl. Mark Chapman doesn't care. He still wants to come, and we will still have a concert here at 7 o'clock. So if you feel like it's laid upon your heart to come and hear him sing gospel songs, and he actually wrote a couple of songs, and he gives a little bit of his testimony throughout the time that he's with us. So come and join us if you can. And I know the last 3 weeks we've been hearing a message on hearing his call. Amen? And I'm going to praise the Lord because somebody has heard the call to start a children's ministry on Sunday mornings with us. So I'm going to praise the Lord for Gabrielle Burbick. And she's going to start today. So praise God and let the children come. Amen?
Amen.
Let's have church.
Suzanne wanted to say something for a minute. She had a little announcement.
Is it on?
Hold it close to your mouth.
Up here?
Yep.
What I'm talking about, I got a letter this week from the Gideons. Ken was a Gideon, and I'm the on the auxiliary. And I'm not asking for money at all. But I got this letter from them, and it's telling us that every day of the month, they have it listed, they will be praying for different churches in our county. Every church in the county is listed in here. And on the 10th of every month this year, our Methodist church will be one of the ones that are praying for. And like I say, they're all listed. Today, the ones that they will be praying for is Damascus Friends Church, Damascus United Methodist, and the DFC, which I'm not sure what that is, in Salem. But each day, there's at least three or two that they'll be praying for. And I think that's a great ministry. And I made some copies. If anybody wants some of these that you want to participate, and praying for other churches. Like I say, I'm not asking for money, but the prayers I think would be great. If we, they're praying for us, we can pray for them. So, and I have a few copies if you want, we can make more.
Thank you, Suzanne.
If you would, if there's no other announcements, please join me in an opening prayer.
Holy Father, and Maker of heaven and earth, you have made all things according to your word. God of flesh, you have made us the head of creation. We are here to worship you and praise your name. May our worship and praises be accepted by you. Refresh our spirits in you. As we begin today, guide us toward your will. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
The opening hymn is Lord of the Dance, page 261, verses 1, 2, and 3.
Praise and good keeping prayer.
always good to be home.
I have a praise.
Go ahead.
We got to see Judy Stover's grandson's big last night at the program. It was very nice. Hi.
Yeah. Donna.
Stephanie is not here today because she took a spill at her office.
Oh, boy.
And she's come with a nice bag and she's having a little difficulty walking. But, hopefully she'll, it's just a bad, bad news.
And Victoria. She wants her wishes to come true. Okay.
A soapbox.
Okay. We don't wish, we just pray to God, right? If you pray to God, if it's something you need, He will allow it to happen.
Like a superwatch.
Okay. One of these days, that superwatch is going to show up. Okay, let's go to the Lord in prayer. Oh, dear Heavenly Father, You are an amazing God. And You are the one, dear Lord, that fills all of our needs. I thank You, dear Lord, for being with us this past week, filling the needs, putting food on our tables and a roof over our heads. Heat in our homes, in our buildings, in our church. You have also, dear Lord, showed us love when we felt unloved. You have showed us in a big way, dear Lord, how You answer prayers. So we do praise Your name, dear Lord, for laying upon Gabrielle's heart to start the children's ministry and not be afraid. Because we only have one child here, I know, dear Lord, that You are laying upon my heart, but we'll start with one. And we praise Your name, dear Lord, for allowing that one to be Victoria. Heavenly Father, You hear all of Victoria's prayers. So I ask You, dear Lord, to allow her to know that You hear them. And allow her needs to continue to be given. Dear Heavenly Father, we join Steve in praising Your name for his move. I know, dear Lord, that being in a new place is different, sometimes hard, but sometimes good. And as he shared, dear Lord, he's not too far away from where his grandfather lived. So it brings nostalgia into his life. Streets that he'll be walking or running on, dear Lord, will bring back memories of his childhood. So I ask You, dear Lord, to be with Steve as he adjusts to this move and just allow him to see You in all of it, dear Lord. We join Bill and Sherry in praising the church family for all of the prayers that they've lifted up for his mom, Jeanette. We ask You, dear Lord, to continue to be with her, continue to keep her safe, and continue to allow her needs to be met. We join Suzanne in praising Your name, dear Lord, for being able to see Tyler. Dear Heavenly Father, mostly we praise Your name for the talents that You have given to him so that he can make people's lives feel better, dear Lord, so that he can be an example of how dreams do come true. Through You, dear Lord, we ask that You continue to be with him and continue to extend your healing hand upon her and allow her to heal quickly. We ask that you continue to be with Cora and Lloyd, and we ask you to continue to be with all those, dear Lord, that are not able to be with us here this morning. We ask that you continue to be with Jeanette and Leland, dear Lord, as they live away from home and where they are, dear Lord, and as they have made it their home. We ask that you be with their caregivers and allow them, dear Lord, to continue to take great care of your children. Dear Heavenly Father, we continue to live in a crazy world, but we also know, dear Lord, that we live in a world where you exist in us. But we ask you, dear Lord, to continue to help us have you and show you to others, dear Lord, wherever you have us go. Dear Heavenly Father, there is good to be known in the world, and allow that your good to be known to us. Dear Heavenly Father, we know that Columbiana schools are preparing to bring you back to the children, dear Lord. Opening up a way, dear Lord, that the children have an option to learn about you during school hours. So I ask you, dear Lord, to be with all of the leaders that are putting this together. We ask that you continue to give them the courage and the strength to do whatever is needed. And we ask you, dear Lord, to send your spirit to the homes of the children, dear Lord, allowing the parents to think that this is a great idea, and allow them, dear Lord, to send the children. I do praise your name, dear Lord, for the children's ministry that we do have here in this church. And I ask you, dear Lord, to just let them build. We ask you, dear Lord, to send the children so that we can play our part in this community in allowing them to know you. And this I pray, dear Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen. If you would join with me now in praying the Lord. If you would turn to page 881 and confirm your faith in saying the Apostles' Creed with me. I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he rose from the dead, he ascended into heaven, and sitteth at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, life.
Good morning, everybody. Good morning. Welcome. We're going to do a praise song that was done by a British pastor named Matt Redman and a worship artist named Pat Perry. It's called Good in My Life.
Above every other name, Jesus is
gifts that have been given here today. I ask you, dear Lord, to bless the gifts, continue to bless the givers, and allow us, dear Lord, to use these gifts in a way that's pleasing to you. This I pray, dear Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Please join me in prayer of dedication. God, power, and patience,
we gather in worship to wait on your presence and to be filled with your power. Jesus healed with your touch and taught us that you are the source of true healing that can make us whole. As we take time now to worship, to offer our gifts to you, we pray that they might be used to bring healing in body, a spirit of appropriate healing on the planet that is growing under our terrorists and greed. Healing on the rural community that is deeply divided by distrust and self-interest. We pray this in Jesus' holy name. Amen.
Oh, sorry.
You want your wishes to come true. You know what? Sometimes life gets hard, and we do have wishes on our heart. So what we learn about in the scripture is that Jesus had a very busy day, and very, very lot of people wanted things from him. And when he went about, people wanted him to heal him. They wanted their wishes to come true. They wanted to be well. And even after sunset, people brought people. Their family, and they came to Jesus and said, please help me, please help me, we need you, we want you. And you know what Jesus did? Early in the morning, he got up and he went to pray, and he went to spend time with his Father. And I think Jesus knew that he needed to pray so that he could give to other people, and he could meet their needs, and he could help them and give them their wishes that they really wanted, because it's really tough to be sick and unwell. But in order to help meet other people's wishes, Jesus spent time in prayer. And that's what we're going to learn about today in Sunday school. We're going to learn about how do we pray and how do we bring those things to God and lay them before his heart, and we can follow in the footsteps of Jesus. Should we go do that? Let's go do it.
Thank you.
Now we'll do the hymn, You Satisfy the Hungry Heart, page 629, verses 1, 3, and 5. You can stand as you are able.
Thank you.
Today we celebrate communion together. So if we would turn to page 12 and join with me. Christ our Lord invites to his table all who love him, who earnestly repent of their sin and seek to live in peace with one another. Therefore, let us confess our sin before God and one another. Merciful God, we confess that we have not loved you with our whole heart. We have failed to be an obedient church. We have not done your will. We have broken your law. We have rebelled against your love. We have not loved our neighbors. And we have not heard the cry of the needy. Forgive us, we pray. Free us for joyful obedience through Jesus Christ our Lord. Hear the good news. Christ died for us while we were yet sinners. That proves God's love toward us. In the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven.
In the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven.
Glory to God. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. And so with your people on earth and all the company of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Holy are you, and blessed is your Son, Jesus Christ. By the baptism of his suffering, death, and resurrection, you give birth to your church, delivered us from slavery to sin and death, and made with us a new covenant by water and Spirit. On the night in which Jesus had given himself up for us, he took bread and he gave thanks to his Father. He gave that bread to his disciples. He said, "This is my body that will be given for you. So take and eat and remember me." When the supper was over, Jesus took a cup and he gave thanks to his Father. He showed that cup to his disciples and he said, "In this cup is the blood of a new covenant, a covenant for the forgiveness of your sins and of many. So take and drink it, and whenever you do, remember me." And so, in remembrance of these, your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice, in union with Christ's offering for us as we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Pour out your Holy Spirit on us gathered here and on these gifts of bread and wine. Make them be for us the body and blood of Christ, that we may be for the world the body of Christ, redeemed by his blood. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one in ministry to all the world, until Christ comes in final victory, and we feast at his heavenly banquet. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit in your holy church, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
Amen.
Isn't it awesome to be loved so much that Jesus gave himself up for us? Not only that, God sent his son. What great love, amen. Please join with me in praying the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
The Old Testament reading today is Isaiah 40, verses 21 through 31. The first part of this reading shows contrast between idols and the living God, and then it speaks of God's faithfulness and empowering grace. Have you not known? Have you not heard? Has it not been told you from the beginning? Have you not understood from the foundations of the earth? It is he who sits above the circle of the earth, and its inhabitants are like grasshoppers, who stretches out the heavens like a curtain and spreads them like a tent to dwell in, who brings princes to naught and makes the rulers of the earth as nothing. Scarcely are they planted, scarcely sown. Scarcely has their stem taken root in the earth, when he blows upon them and they wither, and the tempest carries them off like stubble. To whom then will you compare me, that I should be like him? Says the Holy One. Lift up your eyes on high and see who created these. He who brings out their hosts by number, calling them all by name, by the greatness of his might, and because he is strong in power, not one is missing. Why do you say, O Jacob, and speak, O Israel? My way is hid from the Lord, and my right is disregarded by my God. Have you not known? Have you not heard? The Lord is the everlasting God, your creator of the ends of the earth. He does not faint or grow weary. His understanding is unsearchable. He gives power to the faint, and to him who has no might, he increases strength. Even youth shall faint and be weary, and young men shall fall exhausted. But they who wait for the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. May God add his blessing to the reading of his word.
The gospel reading today comes from Mark chapter 1, verses 29 through 39. Now as soon as they had come out of the synagogue, they entered the house of Simon and Andrew with James and John. But Simon's wife's mother lay sick with fever, and they told him about her at once. So he came and took her by the hand and lifted her up, and immediately the fever left her, and she served them. At evening, when the sun had set, they brought to him all who were sick and those who were demon-possessed. And the whole city was gathered together at the door. Then he healed many who were sick with various diseases and cast out many demons. And he did not allow the demons to speak because they knew him. Now in the morning, having risen a long while before daylight, he went out and departed to a solitary place, and there he prayed. And Simon and those who were with him searched for him. When they found him, they said to him, "Everyone is looking for you." But he said to them, "Let us go into the next towns, and that I may preach there also, because for this purpose I have come forth." And he was preaching in their synagogues throughout all Galilee and casting out demons. This is the word of God for the people.
Thank you, God.
Scripture this week, and it took me back to a couple of weeks ago. And I know I shared with you about a young mother that had passed away. And when she did, my heart was so heavy. And I think I said to you that I wasn't questioning God. I wasn't questioning, like, that He exists. I wasn't questioning that, but I was questioning why her? Why her? And I even shared in our Bible study, I was just saying, you know, when I read the Bible and I hear all these stories, you hear about all these miracles, and people are constantly coming to Jesus and asking for healing, and he does. He does it. You see, that's what our scripture is today. Amen? He left the synagogue and went to Peter's house, and Peter's mother-in-law was sick. And right away, Peter and them said, "Please, heal her. She's sick." And he goes over to her, and he grabs her hand, and he lifts her up, and right away, the fever is gone. While I was reading that, you know, I was thinking this morning, I woke up, and I wasn't feeling very well. And I'm like, "Okay, God, heal me now." But after that, we hear about all of these people that brought their loved ones, brought their friends, brought all these people that were sick or filled with demons, and just brought them all night long to Jesus. And he healed all of them. But see, here's the part that speaks the loudest. And this is actually the scripture that came to mind when I was asking God, why her? You see, the disciples went to Jesus and says, hey, they were looking all over for him, and then they found and said, hey, there's all these people. They're bringing, they're sick, and they're filled with demons, and they need your healing. And Jesus said, we need to go to the next town and the town after that, because that is my purpose. Did you hear it? Because I heard it loud and clear. His healing this side of heaven isn't the purpose he came. Amen?
Amen.
And we as Christians and children of God have to just accept that. And we have to accept the fact that when he takes somebody home, he takes them home for a purpose. For his purpose. And that is so that they will be in the kingdom of God alongside him. And if I ever, the people that I have felt so strong about, like, losing, or, you know, I'm like, why them? If I look at their lives, I realize that they were ready. They were ready. And it came to my mind this morning about the first time when, let me go back. My home church at Berlin Center, it seemed like, and I remember somebody saying one time that it felt like there was a healing ministry there. Because so many people found favor in God, and God allowed them to be healed from anything that they had. It got to be so that I just expected it. because it was Berlin Center, but because we believed. And we prayed. And we asked for that miracle. And the first time that I lost one of my church family that I was very close to hurt so bad. And I prayed hard. His name was Steve Spies. He was the husband of the choir director there. And I worked with him because they added on an addition onto the church. We literally doubled the building. And I worked alongside him and his father very closely because, see, I used to do drafting. And the architect that they had wasn't working fast enough for them. For them to build, so they say, hey, Cyndi, could you do this part? Hey, Cyndi, could you figure out this part? Hey, Cyndi, could you do this? And I would be one step ahead of the architect drawings that would come in. And I worked alongside them for a year, and our relationship was built. He got sick. He was diagnosed with pancreatic cancer. He was only given 6 months to live. And the church prayed. We had those 24-hour praying, fasting times. And we prayed and we prayed. You know what? God gave us 2 years. He gave us 2 years. We can't forget that. We could have only had 6 months, but he gave us 2 years. But it hurt really bad, and I was like, I why, God? Why? He could do so good this side of heaven, right? We could say that. But I talked to his wife, our choir director, and she said, Cyndi, it's okay. It's okay. But she wanted to make sure I was okay. And I heard the story of what he did with each one of his kids. He got a Bible for each one of his kids, and he spent a special time sitting with his child in his room on his deathbed, talking about the Bible and telling them that this will get you through. And making sure that they believe just like he did before he went. How awesome is that? How awesome is that? Because God's purpose this side of heaven is for us to be ready. For us to know Him. So that when He calls us home, we are ready. Amen? And we can trust that He will take care of our loved ones. He will take care of everything that we leave behind. If it means taking care of. Amen? I believe this was a strong message to me, and I pray that it is a strong message to all of you. Because we have all lost loved ones. And we have miracle stories too, right? And sometimes we see those miracle stories and sometimes we don't. And I believe the scripture that we have today is scripture to help us understand why that miracle didn't come. Because the greatest miracle of all was already here. And that is Jesus Christ, our Savior and Redeemer. Amen.
Amen.
To make a way,
yes,
for us in His house. Amen.
Amen.
Please join with me in prayer. Oh, dear Heavenly Father, I thank you for such a powerful message. One to help us understand a little bit more. Maybe not completely, but we're human. And you know that. So I ask you, dear Lord, to walk with us. And when we have questions, dear Lord, I know that you answer them just as you did today. So I ask you, dear Lord, to help us also have that purpose of helping. helping others know you, so that we will all join you in that place you have prepared for each and every one of us one day. Until then, help us to be the ones that reflect you this side of heaven. And this I pray, dear Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen. If you would join with me now in singing, Great is Thy Faithfulness, number 140. Love of God and the guidance of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.